I'm gonna sing, I'm gonna shout, I'm gonna let the reason out that his love goes on forever. I'm gonna take it all the way. I'm gonna pray.
Hey, I'm Pastor Bill, and thanks for joining me here on the Maple Minute this Tuesday, August the 29th, 2023. We've been talking about biblical characters, and today we're talking about asking for wisdom. That is Solomon. And we get to Solomon, I think it's important to understand he was a great man, did some great things. And, well, let's go to 1 Kings chapter 3 and verses number 10 through 14. It says, the Lord was pleased that Solomon had asked for this. What is it? What are we talking about? God had come to Solomon in a dream and asked him what he wanted. Anything he wants, what do you want? And Solomon said, you know what? I know that riches are important. I know that wealth and power and all these things, but you know what? Give me wisdom. Wisdom, because I don't know how to rule your people, God. So don't let me mess up. Give me wisdom. And verse 10 says, the Lord is pleased that Solomon had asked for this. So God said to him, since you have asked for this and have not asked for long life or wealth for yourself, nor have asked for the death of your enemies, but for discernment and administering justice, I will do what you have asked for. I will give to you a wise and discerning heart so that there will never have been anyone like you, nor will there ever be. Verse 13, moreover, I will give you what you have not asked for, both wealth and honor, so that in your lifetime you will have no equal among kings. And if you walk in obedience to me and keep my decrees and commands, as David your father did, I will give you a long life. Wow. You know, shortly after Solomon succeeded his father David, as the king of Israel, God appeared to him in this dream, and the Lord made him an offer. It was an unprecedented offer in Scripture. Anything Solomon wanted. Do you want wealth? Do you want long life? Do you want revenge on your enemies? God said, I'll give it to you. And for all of Solomon's noteworthy accomplishments, the most inspiring thing he did was to utter the words, I want wisdom. They not only set the course for the rest of his life, but they reveal what I would say, three vital truths about wisdom that can still apply to us today. Number one, the selfless pursuit of wisdom pleases God. You see, Solomon asked for wisdom, the ability to discern between good and evil, and to judge fairly, not for his own ego, but for the sake of God's people. He wanted to be a good leader. He wanted to be a godly leader. And God was pleased with that. And that's one of those things, hey, you know what? We need to ask for wisdom, not for our own advancement. It's not, God, give me wisdom so I can make more money. God, give me wisdom so I make good deals. God, give me wisdom so I can get better and things like that. But it's a selfless pursuit of wisdom, and that pleases God. The second thing we find is that wisdom is highly valued by other people. You know, the first test of Solomon's wisdom came when two prostitutes approached him with a seemingly unsolvable dispute. You see, these two women had lived together, and both had given birth to sons. And in the middle of the night, the one woman had accidentally killed her son. And so she took her son and swapped it for the other ones without that lady knowing. And in the morning, they were just all in a tizzy. So they came to Solomon. And Solomon, you've probably heard this story before, but Solomon, went with both the women there before him, claiming to be the mother of this one lone son, infant, Solomon had to use some wisdom. He had to take his wisdom and put it to practice. And that's where we find wisdom is being highly valued by other people. You see, Solomon in his wisdom ordered that they bring a sword and cut the baby, the living baby, in half and give half to each woman. Well, when he said that, the real mom, she backed away and said, no, he's hers, let her have him. And she pleaded with Solomon to give this baby because she loved her son so much, she would rather see her son alive in the hands of another woman than the other way around. So Solomon ordered the baby to be given to the woman, this woman who renounced her claim, realizing that her compassion revealed that she was the true mother. That's an amazing story. It was such an amazing story that it's told that you find rulers all over the world came. The Queen of Sheba came to see the truth about who Solomon was, his wisdom and his wealth and things like that. I think the third thing that we find, the third vital truth about wisdom is that when the pursuit of wisdom is abandoned, bad things happen. See, with fame and fortune come many temptations, and that's true even for Solomon. The highly developed thought process that marks Solomon's public persona seemed to abandon him in his private life. And what do I mean? Solomon married 700 women. He had 700 wives, and if that wasn't enough, he had another 300 concubines or substitute wives. And most of them were foreign. They were idol-worshipping women who came from foreign nations. And over time, they influenced Solomon's heart to go away from God. You see, Solomon didn't keep himself solely unto what God wanted. Wisdom is always the best choice, and that's what we have to realize in these situations. See, wisdom allows you to apply what you know in ways that benefit not just you, but other people. wisdom allows you to use your God-given gifts in extraordinary ways. God reveals the pursuit of wisdom. And since God is the source of all wisdom, a close relationship with Him and His Word is essential to this pursuit of wisdom. The more you understand about God and His desires, what pleases and displeases Him, the better equipped you'll be to make wise decisions. And you have to do it on a daily basis, and that's the lessons we learn. So let's have some questions to think this thing through today. Number one, when was the last time you demonstrated God-honoring wisdom? What situation? And when was the last time you wish you'd shown some God-honoring wisdom? There are times we act foolish. Think of a time in your life that you did something that you realized, like, that was just using God's word to do it right. And then maybe think of a time you did something foolishly and you regret it now, but maybe, you know, you didn't use God's wisdom at all. Number two, what difference can wisdom make in your life and in the lives of others? And that's the question, not in Solomon's life, but in your life. What can wisdom do for you? And how can it help others that you come in contact with? And then number three, what's the best strategy for becoming a wise person or a wiser person? This last one is very important. We answer this one with a lot of thought. So take time, write these questions down. You can pause the video, write these questions down, and go through them. Think these things through. The Bible talks about meditating upon the Word of God. When we talk about meditating, some of it's taking questions like this and pondering truth. A lot of people just read to read as an academic exercise. Don't just read God's Word. Take the time to meditate, think on it, and delve into the truths of God's Word, even as we're trying to help you do that in our studies that we put here on the Maple Minute. So until next time, thanks for joining me here on the Maple Minute. I'm gonna praise Jesus' name, 'cause His love goes on forever. His love reaches to the highest mountain. His love stretches to the lowest valley. His